Welcome watching first part of our video tutorial how to repair hot water high pressure cleaner Elektra Beckum HD100 HW. This power washer is 25-27 years old, and some parts on it are even older, like engine, Portotecnica engine. It's 30 years old. Actually, it is high quality, compact, hot water pressure washer, and I got it for very reasonable price because it was broken. Like most of the things were broken on it. The high pressure hose was blocked, the double coil where the water is heated was blocked, engine was overheating, water pump was leaking, and nozzle was damaged, and I successfully repaired everything and recorded this video tutorial, and I hope it will help to some people, because this kind of pressure washer is in production roughly for 4 decades. It was sold under various brands, like for example HDEm 100WH Elektromaschinen, Electrolux, Portotecnica, Eagle Mitho Plus, or Taskmaster. It's got high quality, very flexible, high pressure hose, 8 meters long. And when I tried to repair it, I found out that nobody in Europe is repairing this pressure washer anymore, as the Elektra Beckum company doesn't exist anymore. It was bought by the Metabo company, German Metabo company, but the brand doesn't exist anymore. So I was looking for a solution and I found one. There are still in production similar machines like Portotecnica, or especially our German company REM Power. German or Slovenian, I'm not sure now. REM Power is still producing them and selling them. So I successfully got a spare parts list, and I would like to thank you to Slovenian company REM Power, that is I guess distributor of these power washers for REM. And thanks to this spare parts list, I was able to find out what O-rings, for example, do you have in the water pump or other parts. This spare part list is from 95% the same as was Elektra Beckum spare part list. This power washer is producing maximum 90 degrees water temperature when it's heating. It's got maximum 100 bars, maximum pressure, but operating pressure is roughly 90 bars, or a little bit less, but usually it's 90 bars. And as you can see, the high pressure gun was on the table, was even built in Western Germany, or there is a written on it, made in West Germany. So hopefully in the next parts, you will have a chance to learn something from it, from this tutorial, and it will help you to cope with the problems that can appear with this kind of machine or similar machines. Before we start to disassemble this machine, I take off the blue top styling cover and show you how it looks underneath it. The diesel tank, because it's electric high pressure washer, but the water is heated by diesel. The diesel tank has got 4 liter capacity. And the double coil, which is not stainless steel, or it's not a copper, it's made of high quality steel, is roughly 18 kgs heavy. The weight of this compact high pressure washer is 52 kgs. and the size is roughly 60 by 40 by 68, if I remember right. As you can see, there is a brand new nozzle for high pressure lamps, and it's for high temperatures. Here you can see how this hot water pressure washer looks without the top styling cover. And beside, I have put on the table the high pressure hose. Look at this, this is nearly 30 years old high pressure hose, and how flexible, how high quality it is. Over here you can see massive high quality water pump with the brass screws and the pressure gauge on it, on top of it. Over here is the pressure regulator. The water flows from the water pump inside the double coil where it's heated. And then over here you are connecting the high pressure hose, and hot water is flowing through this pipe. You can see through the visor level of the oil. Proper level of the oil is roughly in the middle of the visor. Through this you can feel the new oil whenever you are changing, and underneath you've got plastic screw that you are unscrewing whenever you are replacing the oil. Over here is a diesel tank, 4-liter one. And here is the main electric box. There is a thermal fuse, and if the engine, for example, overheated after 1 or 1.5 hours of the work, and it turned it off automatically, this thermal fuse, then you have to press this one to start it again after some time of cooling. Over here you can see the main switch for turning on the machine. This particular power washer does not have a start-stop system. It's got bypass system, so it means that the machine is running, but when you press the trigger, then the pump starts to create a pressure. And over here is another switch when you are turning on the burner, and the diesel is starting to burn and it's heating the water in the double coil. There is a kind of a ventilator that is cooling down the engine, and here is the chimney. There are the spark plugs, two of them, and over here you've got handle. It's made of plastic, but the bottom part is the metal one. This copper wire is a kind of a sensor that is sending the information about the cold water, how cold water is, because through this pipe from the pump runs the cold water. And on this pipe there is, I think you won't see it, but there is another copper wire that is sending the signal how hot the water temperature heated in the double coil is. And when it reaches maximum 90 degrees, then the thermal fuse switch is switching off the burner. Now we will have a closer look from the other side of the machine. On this side we can see the pipe that is connected to the diesel tank, 4-liter capacity diesel tank, and through this pipe and through this filter flows the diesel through this system, and it goes to the front of the power washer. There are two spark plugs and they are starting to burn the diesel, and the diesel is heating the double coil inside the body of the power washer Over here you can see the stainless steel chimney, and over there is a ventilator. I think it's called impeller as a spare part. Now we will have a closer look at the engine. It's a brushless professional high quality engine. We can see the technical details at the label. It was produced in the 1993, it means 30 years ago. You can see yourself that it's really German or German-Italian high quality. If something is built properly, it lasts for decades and does a great job.